Okay. For Gary, can you go through the steps of forgiveness again, sort of in depth with us? And then, simply because you can't get enough about forgiveness, can David also respond as well afterwards?
Yes, Nell's question was, can I go through the three steps of forgiveness again? Well, it's really pretty simple. I think a lot of the answers to these questions are too simple. You know, so people, they tend to resist it a great deal. The first and most important part, and I really do believe this is the most important part, is just to stop yourself when you go to react to something. If somebody comes on a TV screen who you hate, or somebody comes into the room, and you know you don't like them, and you just go to react, and this is the importance of the workbook. You stop yourself. Your mind has become trained to the point where you can stop yourself from thinking with the ego and start thinking with the Holy Spirit. That's the most important step. That's the hardest part. Now, once you stop yourself and you start to think with the Holy Spirit, then everything else that you've learned will come back to you. That's the importance of the holographic thought system, and the thought system of love, the thought system of the Holy Spirit. If you start to think with the Holy Spirit, it'll all come back to you. So you stop yourself and you say, you know something, I made this whole thing up. This is stupid, I made this whole thing up. It's a projection, it comes from me. I wanted that person to be there. I wanted them to be there because now my guilt is in them instead of me. So I want them to be that. I put them there. And then all of a sudden you stop yourself, you change your mind, you realize it's your projection. And that's when you release the whole thing to the Holy Spirit. That's when you say, okay, I'm overlooking the body. That's not you. What you really are is this perfect spirit. Those are the three basic steps. And I really think that understanding that is only going to come from doing it over and over and over again. It's the repetition factor that is so important, which is why A Course in Miracles is also very repetitive, because it has to drill it into our mind. You know, we have to get it kind of like hammered home to us over and over again. But if you do those three basic steps, you just get used to it and you think about it less, it becomes a part of you, and it becomes almost like a habit.
Yeah, that's, I just totally agree with all that, and I think, like Gary was saying, it's like, it takes a lot of practice, and Jesus says a couple things that might be helpful. One of them is an untrained mind can accomplish nothing. And then another one is that you're much too tolerant of mind wandering. I mean, if you put those two together, it's like, okay, it's going to take some discipline here, and like you said, drilling it in. It's going to really, the only way it's going to take hold is through lots and lots and lots of practice.